Good morning all of you. I am Shubham Singh from BCA fifth semester and I am here to present, give a presentation on the topic of accounting, that is the accounting cycle, and me and my dear friend Mr. Harsh Kumar will give the presentation. I will cover the accounting cycle topic and my dear friend Mr. Harsh will cover the topic of features of accounting and objective of accounting. So let's start with the accounting cycle. Accounting cycle is a step-by-step process of any business transaction of a particular financial year. मतलब ये क्या है कि एक step-by-step process होता है किसी भी business में हम जो transaction किए हैं उसका सारा ब्यौरा इसमें हम रखते हैं. Accounting cycle किस किस तरह से काम करती है, तो first of all we identify the transaction, identify after identification we collect it, analyze it, and after classification we record it and then summarize it. And this is the process through which the accounting cycle works. Here you can see the steps, steps of the accounting cycle. In this accounting cycle, first of all the we measure the financial transactions, then what are the transactions of business during a period of time, and then after we add it to the journal. Journal is a day-to-day entry. Where all the transactions are recorded on a day-to-day basis in a chronological order. Then after we prepare a ledger on the basis of the journal. Ledger is a book of account in which we kept all the business transactions related to a particular business in a various accounts separately. मतलब इसमें क्या होता है कि हम अलग-अलग accounts बनाते हैं. उस अलग-अलग accounts को हम मैनेज करते हैं, सेपरेटली मैनेज करते हैं, अलग अलग ट्रांजेक्शन हुआ उसके बाद को हम मैनेज करते हैं. इसमें सारा ब्यौरा रहता है, क्रेडिट और डेबिट का अलग अलग कॉलम में हम मैनेज करते हैं इसमें. देन आफ्टर वी मेक अ ट्रायल बैलेंस, एंड ट्रायल बैलेंस इज बेसिकली यूज्ड टू find out the sum, that the sum of all the credits and sum of all the debits is equal. मतलब credit और जो debit हो रहा है उसका total sum equal आना चाहिए. मतलब कोई error अगर ledger account में होता है तो trial balance इसलिए बनाया जाता है कि उसको उसमें maintain किया जा सके. Then we make an internal statement. Internal statement is a financial statement in which all the revenue, all the profitability of the business is captured. And then after we make, finally we make balance sheet. But in balance sheet, in this statement we measure that the what is the company's assets, liabilities, and the shareholders' equity. This all is mentioned in the balance sheet. And this whole process will goes on till the business ends. जब तक business नहीं होता, हर एक साल, हर एक period of time पे accounting cycle इसी तरह से काम करती है. Now I will like for Mr. Harsh to present the next slide, that is the features of accounting.
Thank you so much. First of all, I would like to say thank you to invite me. And good morning all of you. And good morning, sir. Today my topic is business accounting, feature of accounting. So first of all, in feature, first feature is used by organization. In this feature, accounting is applied by the organization performing business activities, either profit or non-profit. And next feature, recording of economic events. In this feature, we concerned with regarding of economic event, that is financial transaction. And next feature is recording and communication. In this feature, accounting is a process of identifying the transaction to be in a systematic, to be recorded and check the financial transaction in systematic way. And next feature is user of accounting information. In this feature, accounting is complete when information about economic event are communicated. So I will come to the next topic, objective of accounting. In this topic, objective is to keep, first objective is to keep systematic and complete record of all the financial transactions. And second is to ascertain the financial position of the business. And third objective, to provide information to various group of end user. And fourth objective, to facilitate the decision making. In this objective, we create a balance sheet when we done a financial transaction. So in this objective, we create balance sheet. And last, to meet legal requirement. Thank you.
Good morning, all of you. Today, me and my friends are here to give a presentation which is guided by our respected sir. So, our presentation is the based on the topic accounts. So, I would like to call my friend Saurabh to go further.
My name is Saurabh Kumar from ECAQ 5th semester. Okay, my topic is I cover three topics: accounting cycle, and type of accounting. Our first topic is accounting. So, first question is, what is accounting? Accounting is the art of recording, classifying, and summarizing the financial data. Accounting has been defined by different ways, by different authors. The concept of accounting changed with the passage of time. Accounting cycle. Accounting cycle is complete sequence from the recording of the financial transaction to the preparation of financial account. Okay, for my further presentation, I want to call Karan. So please, Karan.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everybody. My name is Karan Kumar. I am a student of BCA 5th semester. Now I am going to cover the steps of accounting. First of the balance, first of all, balance of accounts from opening balance sheet and day-to-day financial transaction are recorded in the journal. The second step is ledger. Transaction recorded in the journal and transferred to the respective accounts opened in the ledger. Now, third step is trial balance. In this stage, a list showing the balance of each and every account is prepared. Trial balance is equal to sum of credit, side of balance. The fourth step is income statement. Trading and profit and loss or income statement is prepared to find out real profit or loss in the accounting period. The fifth step is financial position or balance sheet. Finally, at this stage, balance sheet is prepared. This shows the final position of the business at the end of the period. Now, I am going to cover types and branches of accounting. First type is financial account, second one is cost accounting, and third one is management accounting. Now, financial accounting. Financial accounting is the original form of accounting. Financial accounting is mainly covered with the recording, classifying, and summarizing the financial statement. The primary purpose of financial accounting is to paint a clear picture of a company's operational performance over a specified period of time. Second one is cost accounting. Cost accounting is a process of assigning cost to cost objects that typically include a company's products, services, and any other activities that involve the company. Cost accounting is helpful because it can identify where a company is spending its money, how much it earns, and where money is being lost. Now, the third one is management accounting. Management accounts are financial reports produced for the business owners and managers, generally monthly or quarterly, normally a profit and loss reports and a balance sheet. The advantages of management accounting are like controlling business operation, planning, decision making. Thank you. Now I would like to call Uttam for his topic.
Good morning, my name is Uttam Kumar and I am here for presenting advantage of accounting. Advantage of accounting. Accounting helps in estimating the profit of the financial, and it assists the managing the businesses, and it also provides systematic record of business transactions, and it also ensures the profit in the court of law. Accounting facilitates the cooperative studies, and then after and it also facilitates correct payment of taxes. Now the disadvantage will be covered by the Chandra Bhushan. Thank you.
So everybody, talking about the disadvantages or the limitations of accounting, there are some points. So only monetary transactions. So basically, the accounting is the record of only money transactions in which the money is involved. Now second one, asset cost. So in accounting, the assets are accounted on the basis of their cost, not on the basis of their market price. So personal journey. As you may know, accountants have various principles of accounting. So accountant may use some principles which you are not following with, and it is totally based on the accountant to which principle he wants to use. So not exact. So accounting is not, sometimes we use a value or a range of for some price or some certain values. So it is cannot say that accounting is exact. Not a good tool for management. So as you know that accounting is the record of the past events. So it cannot be a good tool to predict the future or to make plans according on the basis of that data. So now the last and the most important point is the conflict between accounting principles. So there are some accounting principles like the conservation concepts, and there are some there is one called known as the other principles, conservation principle. For conservation principle, in the conservation principle, all the assets are recorded on the basis of their costs, not on the basis of their market values. And the other principle, there all the goods are done on the basis of their market price, not on the cost. And these are constitutive. They should be always be made a refreshed etc. Thank you.
I am here to present presentation on the accounting, and my topic is types of company. You all know that around 10 different types of company are present, but I discuss only 4 types of company, and that is my agenda of this presentation. So I start from government company. So government company are those company in which lose at least 51% of share capital are held by either central government or state government. So example of the government company is just like Hindustan Steel Limited, and you also know that government company also known as mixed ownership company. And move to the second company, like foreign company. A foreign company are those company in which whose headquarters present outside of the India and perform all the business activity in India and even like Coca-Cola and Dollar. And move to the third, that is holding company. Holding company are those company in which we do not do anything for generating revenue. It is the only parent company. Most of the financial investment banks are holding company, like Bank of America and Citigroup are holding company. And last, registered company. Registered company are those company which follow more law of the country, like Google Map and all Microsoft product, to follow the rules and regulation of the country.
Presentation on the topic business accounting and EI. There are two more members in my team, Simran Kumari and M.D. Rea. So, the first slide will be taken by Simran Kumari.
Respected sir, and my dear friend, my name is Simran Kumari. I am from BCA fifth semester, and these are the topic that we discuss today. First, meaning of accounting, and my dear friend, happy good morning to all of you. My name is Simran Kumari. I am from BCA fifth semester. Today, I am present here to discuss on this topic. First, meaning of accounting, advantage and disadvantage, type of accounting. There are three types of accounting: financial accounting, management accounting, and cost accounting. And last topic, that is role of accounting. Meaning of accounting. The first question that comes into our mind, who is the father of accounting? And he is the father of accounting, Lucas Pacioli. And meaning of accounting. Accounting is the art of recording, classifying, and summarizing in a significant manner, and in terms of money, transactions, and events, which are in part of the list of financial character, interpreting the result thereof. Advantage of accounting. First, advantage of accounting is to maintenance of business record. Second, that is preparations of financial statement. Third, that is comparison of result. Fourth one, decision making. Fifth, evidence in legal matter. Provide information to related parties. Help in taxation's value. Valuations of business. Last one, replacement of memory. And disadvantages of accounting. First one, express accounting information in terms of money. Second, accounting information is based on estimate. Accounting information is based on maybe based recording of its assets at the original cost. Manipulations of accounts. Money as a measurement of changes in value, and so on. Type of accounting. There are three types of accounting. First, that is financial accounting. Second one, that is cost. And last one, management accounting. Over to Ashish.
So,
as my friend has said, there are three types of accounting: financial accounting, managerial accounting, and cost accounting. First, I discuss financial accounting. Financial accounting is primarily concerned with completing and compiling of information for financial reports. It means financial report means we have money transaction in that. For external reports, financial accounting works with their colleagues and managers to strategize how company can more profitable. This is a very important account because it shows us how the company can grow. They track all financial activity records in a ledger. They track all financial activities like how the goods came, in which all that money matters. Financial accounting will be concerned with accurately recording and reporting financial transactions that have already occurred in respect to actual data. Second type is management accounting. It is a form of accounting used in business worldwide. This accounting type is used in all over the world. Management accounting is designed to provide management with the information necessary to make high-level decisions for the business. Management accounting information is shared exclusively with others in an organization. The last type is cost accounting. Cost accounting can be seen as a subcategory of managerial accounting. The activities of cost accounting will affect both financial and management accounting. Cost accounting are responsible for documenting, presenting and reviewing manufacturing costs. They also work with managers to decide on further decisions based on the financial forecast and the progress of production. In this accounting, we see how much we had created, manufactured things and how much we have gained from that. On that basis, we can see that how much we have to more create. Over to Rehan.
Thank you, Anish. Growth accounting. The purpose of accounting is to help stakeholders, parties who are able to make decisions. Accounting consists of measuring and summarizing business activities, interpreting financial information, communicating the results to the management and other decision makers. It's impossible to run an organization or to make a sound investment decisions without accurate, timely financial information. It's the accountant to prepare this information. The hard part is analyzing, interpreting and communicating information and doing so clearly while effectively interacting with people from all business activities. Thank you.